What's up, folks? Your buddy Fatalroadie. Tonight we're going to be doing the results for the Fastlane pay-per-view. We started off with our first match 40 minutes into the kickoff show. Shinsuke Nakamura and Rusev versus Xavier Woods and Big E from the New Day. Prior to this match, a stagehand tells Kofi Kingston that the McMahons want to see him in regards to the WWE Championship match. I'll get more into that later. But this was an okay match. There was a lot of near falls. There was some interference with Lana and Rusev to turn the momentum to the heels. But the New Day hit the up-up-down-down on Rusev to get the pin. We now go to the main card, and our opening match is McMiz versus the Usos for the SmackDown Tag Team Championship. This is a pretty good match. Shane McMahon intercepted Jey Uso in midair with a dropkick. The Miz went for a frog splash on Jimmy Uso, but he got his knees up. He rolls up the Miz to retain the titles. After the match, the Miz and Shane McMahon meet up with the Miz's dad. They hug it out for a little bit, and as they start to leave for the ramp, Shane McMahon attacks the Miz, beats him down, which is pretty much a shock by everybody and myself because everybody thought that the Miz was going to be the one to do the turning. The Miz's dad stood there helpless as Shane McMahon put the triangle on the Miz and chokes him out. Then we have Elias in the ring wasting time, which then brings us to our next match, Mandy Rose versus Asuka. Sonya Deville is at ringside. This is an end match. Sonya Deville interfered quite a bit. She flips up the ring skirt to grab a kendo stick. Mandy Rose bounces off the rope and apparently slips on the ring skirt. Asuka gets in a quick kick and gets the pin to retain her title. After the match, Sonya Deville is trying to apologize to Mandy Rose. She blows her off. Okay, this bit's been going on for quite a while too. Backstage, Big E and Xavier Woods meets up with Kofi outside of the McMahon's office. They go in, they plead their case to get Kofi into the WWE Championship match. Vince McMahon says it's going to be a triple threat match, and Kofi Kingston better get out to the ring because his match is going to be next. He runs out to the ring, and it's then announced that it's going to be a handicap match with Kofi Kingston against the bar. Sheamus and Cesaro flat out beat down Kofi. The crowd is sitting there chanting, "This is boring," which I can't really blame them. The rest of the New Day come out for the save, but are intercepted by Nakamura and Rusev. The bar hit a double white noise on Kofi, get the pin. Then we have Elias in the ring once again, wasting more time. Yeah. We then have a triple threat match for the Raw Tag Team Championships. Aleister Black and Ricochet versus Chad Gable and Bobby Roode versus The Revival. This is a pretty good match. There was a lot of high flying from Ricochet. And as most triple threat matches, there is a bit of chaos. The Revival hit the Shatter Machine on Chad Gable, got the pin, and retained their titles. Then the one missing match from the kickoff show, Rey Mysterio versus Andrade Cien Almas, now became a fatal four-way, adding on R-Truth and Samoa Joe for the United States title. This is a wild match, including Samoa Joe doing a suicide dive. Joe locks in the Coquina Clutch on Rey Mysterio to retain his title, but the one key point that they pointed out through all this is Rey Mysterio didn't tap out, he just flat out passed out. Then we have Sasha Banks and Bayley versus Nia Jax and Tamina for the Women's Tag Team Championship. This is pretty much an entire botch fest, especially from Tamina and Nia Jax. Bayley reverses the Nia Jax powerbomb into a Hurricane Rana and catches the pin, and they retain their titles. Sadly, I don't think this is the last we're going to see this match. Afterwards, Nia Jax and Tamina beat down Bayley and Sasha Banks. Beth Phoenix, who's out at commentary, stands up to Tamina. They fight. Nia Jax lays them out.
Okay.
We then go to the triple threat match, as mentioned by Vince McMahon, for the WWE title. Kevin Owens versus Daniel Bryan versus Mustafa Ali. Throughout most of this match, the crowd was chanting, "We want Kofi." This is an match. Rowan got involved, as you could probably expect. Daniel Bryan got the pin on Mustafa Ali to retain. After the match, Rowan palm slams Mustafa Ali. Like I said, We then have Charlotte Flair versus Becky Lynch. If Becky Lynch wins, she's added into the championship match at WrestleMania. Once again, another match. Charlotte Flair got the figure eight on Becky Lynch. And then Ronda Rousey comes out, attacks Lynch, causing a disqualification, so Becky Lynch wins this, and is then added to the match at WrestleMania. Ronda Rousey walks up the ramp, points at the sign, and then walks off. And for the third time in a row, Elias is out in the ring wasting time. After we get yet another Lacey Evans drive-by, Elias eats an RKO from Randy Orton, and then AJ Styles comes out of nowhere and hits Orton with a phenomenal forearm. Then we go to our main event, The Shield versus Bobby Lashley, Drew McIntyre, and Baron Corbin. Once again, this is another match. Although I will say it's good to see Roman Reigns and The Shield back, albeit for one last time, but it's already a match that we've already seen about 629 times. About halfway through the match, all hell breaks loose, all the way up to the point where I think the ref could have counted everybody out 10 times over. Bobby Lashley gets a curb stomp, Drew McIntyre gets powerbombed through a table, and then The Shield surround Baron Corbin in the ring. Corbin eats a super kick, Superman punch, and a dirty deeds, and is then triple powerbombed for the pin. The Shield celebrate in the ring as we end tonight's pay-per-view. This pay-per-view actually started off pretty good, and then towards the last half, it just went downhill. I think the only real saving grace for the last half of the pay-per-view is the Shield reunion. Other than that, the last half, I really couldn't care less. Fastlane is usually the poorest out of all of the pay-per-views anyways, especially with it being the road to WrestleMania. But we'll have to see on Raw and SmackDown how everything falls out. And that'll do it for my review for Fastlane pay-per-view. Leave a comment down below what you thought of this pay-per-view, what you thought of this video. If you liked it, please give me a thumbs up. Don't forget to share and subscribe. I've been Fatalroadie. You've been awesome. Thank you very much for watching. And remember, if it's too loud, you're too old. See ya.